गुड इवनिंग गाइस, गुड इवनिंग, गुड इवनिंग, गुड इवनिंग, गुड इवनिंग। हेलो हेलो,
सर वी कैन हियर यू।
वी कैन हियर यू सर।
यस सर, वी कैन हियर यू सर।
नो, देयर वाज अ कॉल आल्सो, सो आई वाज रिस्पोंडिंग टू दैट। थैंक यू वेरी मच। आई कुड सी योर चैट, सी योर चैट। ओके गाइस, ओनली 10 क्वेश्चंस? या भरत, व्हाट हैपेंड? आई एम टोटली फाइन, डोंट स्प्रेड दिस रूमर दैट आई हैव कफ और समथिंग। नॉट एट ऑल। यस, यस्टरडे देयर वाज लाइक a tired throat or something like that, but yes, it's totally fine. Yesterday also there wasn't any cough. Okay, oh, NAFL champions are here. I thought you guys might not be here, reason being your term test going on. Yeah, term, like, sorry, like UTs, unit tests. Okay, sorry, sorry, sorry. Okay, so 50 people here, and here I am. We are talking about physics today. Okay, it's 4th of July, and here we go for the first question. If A is equals to this much and B is equals to this much, then what will be the magnitude of A cross B? Relax, calculate and respond. Relax, calculate and respond. That's the beauty, is you guys are calculating and responding because the speed of receiving the tsunami of responses is decreased. Good. A is given, B is given, perform A cross B and calculate its magnitude. Yeah, NAFL, I'm sorry beta, because like you guys told ki you will not be here. RNR dead, no lies. Vector is over at RNR. Oh, how come? Acha, okay, no problem. No problem, no problem, no problem. No problem. No, no, no. 23 people got it right. Relax. First of all, let's learn cross product for a while. Okay. First of all, let's learn cross product for a while. How to perform cross product? Please mute. Good. Thank you. Okay. Relax, 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 relax. First, understand how to perform cross product, because that will be required for further questions as well. Okay. Relax. Now see, whenever there is a vector A, B, it has to be performed for cross product. You go for I, J, and K. Please, for RNR and NAFL, okay? I guess for NAFL, I have covered a minor part of it, but it's okay. No problem. Please.
Sir, minus J.
Not here. Not required here. 1, 2, okay, and 2, minus 2, and 4, okay. Then, yes, while expanding, you write I minus j plus k, okay. So, when you calculate I, you hide the row and column associated with I. You will get the answer as 1 into 4 minus, as a part of the formula, minus 4. Got it?
So can you repeat that part again, please?
Repeat, which is, see, you will write I, J, K, first line. Coefficients of I, J, and K from vector number 1. Coefficients of I, J, and K from vector number 2. Okay? When you have to, then you will write I minus J and K. Okay? For calculating the coefficient of I, you will hide the row and column associated with I. You will see 4 numbers, a square. You will cross multiply them and subtract. So 1 into 4 is 4. Minus, as a part of formula, minus 2 into 2 is minus 4. G, I, got it? Right? I am only talking to, right now, I am only talking to NAFL and RNR. Clear? Good. Then you want to calculate for J. Okay, what will you do? You will hide the row and column associated with J. Clear? What you see? 3 into 4, 12. Minus, as a part of formula, 2 into 2. Clear? No messages from anyone excluding RNR and NAFL. This is not Centamar. Right now I am teaching them something. Please do not interfere. Yeah, good. Then comes K. You will hide the row and column associated with K. What you will see? 3 into minus 2, minus 6, minus, as a part of formula, 2 into 1, 2. G, I. Got it, my dear friends from RNR and NAFL? Good. What is the answer? This is 8i minus 8j minus 8k. The answer will be 8 root 3 when it comes for magnitude. G, I. Got it?
Sir, can you calculate the magnitude once?
No, beta. 8 square plus 8 square plus 8 square, square root of 3 times of 8 square. So it will be 8 root 3.
Yeah, okay, got it.
Okay?
Yeah.
Dhruv got my root. Okay. Sure? Everyone got it? Yeah. Ready? Sure. Now, guys, throughout this session, wherever the cross product has to be performed, this is going to be the method. Okay, NAFL and RNR. Okay, good. This is the shorter method. Okay, so let's look at the leaderboard for 23 people.
So today only cross product or even dot product?
One or two questions might be there for dot product as well. Whenever it will be required, it will be thoroughly mentioned. Abhishek is the fastest one. Siddharth is there. Anvi is there. Okay. Pratham, Jagrav, Himanshu, Dhruv, Srijan, Gandhar, and Crocodile. Good. Here we go to the next question. Next question is an instruction. Read that. Torque, or also called as moment, or also called as moment of force, or also called as rotational force or turning effect, is the rotational equivalent of linear force. Okay, mathematically, torque is equal to the cross product of vector and force. Clear? Vector of position, that is position vector and force. Got it? What is the formula noted? That torque wherever R's
is can I have cross it product.
Yes, please.
So what do you mean cross product of position vector and force? Isn't it like so is force also going to be a vector?
Force is a vector, na?
Okay, fine.
Yeah, good. Okay. Force is mass into acceleration. Acceleration is a vector, mass is a scalar. Okay? Good. Only 40 people marked it, whereas we have minimum 50 people there. Chalo. May I proceed? The torque of the force F is given acting at the point R is given about the origin B. Quickly, you know what has to be done. The previous statement was the hint, was the knowledge, was the concept required for it. Good, Karan. Guys, relax and respond. 48 people have responded to this.
So for this, you could just find which is the correct answer just by getting the first value of I.
Good, very good. See, what my dear friend just now said, he said, this was the definition. Okay, now this is the question. If you will check, you don't have to save a time is a secondary thing. What he said, he said, in order to save time, why are you calculating all? Because all are distinct, just calculate anyone. Yes or no? Right?
Search D, can you fix it?
Repeat.
So the answer is D.
Sir, it is D. Sir, the answer is D.
Alpha, Bravo, Charlie or Delta?
Delta.
Very good. Claps. Look at the definition, my dear friends.
Is position vector into force.
Now look here. What have you guys done? Got your mistake? Yes, I will solve it up. By the very definition which we just now learnt, torque is...
So I don't get it. How is it?
Yes or no? The definition Sir. Which we learnt now, torque is R cross F. Yes or no? Are you relax, guys? See, this is the definition, right? What is torque? Torque is position vector multiplied with force. Okay. Here it is. Position vector multiplied with force. Now, what my dear friend suggested, he said, why are we calculating all? We can just calculate one and get the answer. Right? Okay, so he said, sir, okay, anyway, if someone want to perform, they can perform the whole product, but I am not going to do that. Okay, got it? Now, if you want to comprehensively solve, I am solving comprehensively here. I, J, K, R, 3, 2, 3, F, 2, minus 3, 4, right? Again, same thing. Just for I will have 8 minus minus 9, which is 17 I. I have my answer. Got it? Eleven people marked bravo. No problem. Monisha, what happened, beta? Unmute and talk to me.
So in cross product, from this observation, I can tell if we switch the thing, if we do F cross R, then it becomes minus one into R cross F.
Exactly. Got it?
Okay.
Yeah. So if you... Yeah, exactly. Good. If you remember, while discussing also, we have stated it, ki A cross B is equal to minus of B cross A. What is the proof of it? I'll tell you. This I, J, K is the proof of it. If you'll do I into J, you will get K. But if you'll do J into I, you will get minus K. Yes or no? Got it, everyone? Got it. Be aware, be alert. Okay? Sure. Read it properly. That's why I have kept 10 questions only. Sure? Clear? R for ready, everyone? My R&R friends and my NAFL friends. Okay. Sure. Leaderboard. Jagrav, Himanshu, Namrata, Pratik, and yes, very good. Very good. Very good. Sure. Here we go to the next one. A cross B is equal to C. Then, which of the following statement is wrong? Wrong statement. Good, good, Dhruv. Very good. Relax. Relax. Good, Aditya. Raghav Pandey, very good. No problem, Nishant, no problem. Raghav is so impatient. Huh? No problem, guys. Relax, relax. The definition of cross product is the answer. Everyone has voted. Very good. Very good. Oh, look here. No problem, guys. No problem. Relax. See, the definition of cross product says A cross B will be equal to magnitude of A multiplied with magnitude of B multiplied with sine theta and a unit vector which is mutually perpendicular to both. Mutually perpendicular to both A and B. That means whatever comes as an outcome, please note, whatever comes as an output of a cross product between two vectors, that output is mutually perpendicular to both. That it will be perpendicular to A, it will be perpendicular to B. Sure? Hence, it will be perpendicular to A plus B as well. Yes, it will be parallel to A cross B. Okay? Sure? By A cross B is nothing but C, na? You could have just replaced the value. The answer is C cannot be perpendicular to C. Okay? G, I got it? Very good. Very good. Relax. Very good. Relax. Very good. Very good. One, two, and next. The leaderboard. Nishrat is now answering it. You had to just substitute. Pratham was the fastest one to respond. Very good, Pratham. And here we go to the next question. If for two vectors A and B, A cross B is zero, the vectors are perpendicular, are parallel, are at 60 degree, are at 30 degree. The vectors are perpendicular, parallel, 60 degree or at 30 degree. Very good, very good. What was the definition just now is the answer for it. If you know a single term in the definition, you have the answer. Relax, relax, relax. Good. 41 people have answered by now. 42, 43, 44, 45, 46. Good, 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 good. Good, Ritvik. Good, Siddharth. No problem. Why so much time for this question? Because I know my dear friends will need the time. See, everyone hasn't voted yet. Now they have voted. And yes, we have 14, 35, 5 and 1. 35 people answering it. Very right. Because if A cross B is equals to 0, it implies that sine theta is equal to 0 and theta equal to 0 degree. That means they are parallel. GI. Got it? Simple. If dot product is equals to 0 implies that perpendicular. Cross product equal to 0 implies that parallel. Or anti-parallel. Okay? It can be anti-parallel as well. Okay? So. Yeah. Good. Good. So let's look at the shuffle leaderboard. So yes, 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 yes. Himanshu, Jagrav, Nitin, Anuya, Aditya. Anuya was the fastest one to respond. Very good. And here we go to the next question. The angle between the vectors A cross B and B cross A is A cross B and B cross A. The hint was there in the previous solution. Previous solution. A cross B and
so
B
someone
cross
even said this out in that question where I had said you could use the shortcut method.
Yeah. Yeah. Raghav. I told you the last solution was a straight hint. Let's see who all like it. Relax. 53 people, two more people yet to answer. Time up. Everyone has voted. Good. Guys, please, I'm shocked. I'm in terrible shock. Guys, you know from the first question, from the last question, that A cross B is equals to minus B cross A. Please, right? They are in opposite direction. If they would have been in same direction, then zero. But they are in opposite direction, so 180. Relax, guys. No, not this. It's not a class. Mute yourself.
So I'm slightly confused. I don't understand.
Relax. No problem. Sure? Relax. Acha, you got this line. How many of you got this line? Accepted. This is very well accepted. Right? Good. Very well accepted. Good. Sure. And you are also clear that whenever there are two opposite vectors, their angle between them is 180 degrees. Yes or no? Clear? Yep. Good. Now, okay. Please understand. If here, there are two vectors at zero and you have to round them to 180 degree, you cover a semicircle. A semicircle is pi into radius. So you call it pi. For a full circle, you have to rotate it 2 pi. 2 pi. 2 pi is 360 degree and pi is 180 degree. If you are not aware about this, I'm sorry.
So Tushar sir was teaching this just the other day.
Exactly.
Radian.
Yeah, this have been covered beta indirectly. Might not be directly, but many a times indirectly this information has been delivered.
So now you are the new trap king.
I am not the trap king. I can't be the trap king. My each solution is related to the next question. You know, I arrange the question very systematically.
Sir, could you do it once more?
Yes, Peter. Please, see. When, understand this, nothing. When you complete a circle, right or not, then you cover 360 degree. Okay? And in that case, you cover 2 yes, pi sir. R. Okay? That is 360 into R. So, 2 pi is 360 degree. R pi is 180 degree. Got it?
Okay, yes, sir.
Got it? Good. Very good. Very good. No problem. Sure. And now, Jagra, very good. Raghav was the fastest one to respond. No problem. Here we go to the next question. What is the unit vector perpendicular to the following vectors? Now, if you remember, two questions back, there was a solution for this. In the explanation, you had the solution for this. What is the unit vector perpendicular to the following vectors? Is there general awareness tomorrow, sir? Dhruv, I am not aware about it, bache. Okay? If there will be, Tushar bhai will write down to you. Okay?
Sir, I realized after solving that all the denominators are the same. Why? Sir. Why did you put all the denominators as the same? I solved it. It could have saved me 20 seconds.
Unsure about denominator. But there is no surety required for denominator. So 10, 11, 23, positive. Positive sign. Very positive sign. Very positive sign. So yes, here while explaining this, here, while going through this, we like to this and all, we been through the concept that the cross product.
Sir, it did not take my answer.
Repeat.
Sir, it did not take my answer. I clicked on, see, it did not take it. It said you didn't vote in time.
Sorry, Vijay. Like, I literally can't help you with this because it's done. Okay. Sorry. Let's see if it repeats, then we'll look for a solution. Okay. 2, 2, minus 1, 6, minus 3, j. Now understand. Again, the same method you can opt for. Again, the same method you can opt for. What?
So you didn't need to calculate I or the denominator.
What you want to calculate there? I have a
so only J and K.
Only J and K? Good, 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 good. Now, I have a reverse solution for it. Should I suggest you that? The reverse solution.
Yes, sir.
You know, reverse solution. I am telling you reverse solution. If your brain is working in complete verticals of vector, then you know the answer will be perpendicular to both of them. Yes or no? So the dot product, which is very easy to calculate, should be zero. If only if I don't want you, I don't want to insist this, right? But yes, if I would have been at your place, my approach to save a time would have been ki bhai, all these are the cross product of these. Okay. That means a cross product, which we saw at C, should be perpendicular to this one, should be perpendicular to this one, or both, and all that, right? So what I'll do the dot product with any of them, and we'll find whenever the dot product is coming to zero, will be my answer, GI. Got it or not? Because dot product is way easier to perform than cross product. It's lengthy, cross product is lengthy also, and complicated also, whereas dot product is just a bacha thingy, right? And you can see my answer is there. Yes or no? This is C. This is coming out as 2 plus 20 plus 18. Oh, if this would have been minus, would have been a lottery. Okay, change the sign. Charlie is the answer. 10 seconds. GI, got it or not? Now let's do it formally. The way we are conducting this, let's do it formally. Let it take some time, no problem. So what we'll do, by phi. Cross product of these. Okay. So I j k 2 minus 1 6 minus 3 into 2. Okay. For example, I calculated I. What I'll have? Just for you guys, I'll have 4 minus 3, which is 1. Okay. So, clear? But the problem is, there is no requirement of calculation of I. Why? Because it's same everywhere. Right? Let's go for J. Okay? J will be 4 minus minus 6. Okay. With a negative sign. So it is minus 10, which is available either at Bravo or at Charlie. Yes or no? Clear till here? Now let's go for K. Minus 6 minus 12 minus 18, which is here. Charlie is the answer. Got it? Beta, if you remember the process I told you, I into minus J into plus K. Right? See beta, what answer you are getting is not a unit vector. In order to make it a unit vector, you will have to divide the vector by its own magnitude. Right, Tanya? Yeah. So, no problem. Let's go for the leaderboard. Himanshu is not there. Jagrav was the fastest one to respond. Very good, Jagrav. Excellent. Here we go to the next one.
Bot.
If A cross B is equal to root 3 times of A dot B, then the value of magnitude of A plus B is, I have taken it long to the revision. Relax, read and respond. You have to only look at one particular part of the answers. That will be there. Simple. What you guys need for this question are the remembering or the memory of the values of sine, cos and tan. Sine 0, 30, 45, 60, 90. Cos 0, 30, 45, 60, 90. Tan 0, 30, 45, 60, 90. Okay. Is there T by F? I couldn't understand, beta. Tanvi? Okay.
True or false.
Achha, true or false. No. There isn't any true or false. Only 13 people got it right. Relax, guys. Read. Concentrate. Read. See. If you expand this, you will get A into B into sine theta. If you expand this, you will get root 3 A into B into cos theta. AB got cancelled. You have tan theta equal to root 3. That means theta equal to 60 degree. Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes or no? Okay. Sure. Now, what I was saying, you have to only look at the part of the addition where theta is involved. A square, B square is not. Plus 2AB cos theta. What is cos 60 degree? 1 by 2, 2 and 2 got cancelled. Only AB should be there, which is there in delta. GI, got it? Okay, I repeat. By this, you got that theta is equal to 60 degree. Okay. In the addition, theta is involved as the third part. 2AB cos theta, which is 2AB 1 by 2 cancelled. Only AB should be visible. Okay, delta is the answer. GI. Okay, Shivam, no problem. Good. Look at the lead board. Very good, Jagrav. Very good, Srijan. Very good, Sriram. Very good, Prateek. Tanvi. Siddharth was the fastest one to respond. Very good, Siddharth. Here we go to the next question. Read it. Read the instructions carefully. Don't give a thumbs up without reading it, please. When a force causes a body to move, work is being done on the object by the force. Okay. So, work is measure of energy transferred when a force moves an object through a distance d. Okay. When work is done, energy has been transferred from one energy store to another. Okay. Energy transferred is equal to work done. Mathematically, most of you will be like, sir, bas yahi padhna tha. Mathematically, work is the dot product of force and displacement vector. Good. I am waiting for everyone to read it. Good. Post reading, you have to give a thumbs up at the down, like at the side. Sorry. Good. 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 Achha, I shouldn't have mentioned so that dot wait. Word. Yeah, I'm waiting.
So can you please wait?
Yeah.
So if you hadn't mentioned the dot, I wouldn't have seen it.
Okay, thank you. Chalo. When everyone will respond, I'll proceed. No problem. Okay. R for ready, everyone.
So how many more questions are there?
Two more, bete. Here we go. A force F acting on a particle causes a displacement S in its own direction. If the work done is 6 joule, then the value of C will be. Relax. अरे बच्चे See, work done has to be calculated. Work done is given as 6. So the dot product should be equal to 6. Do the dot product between these two vectors. What happens, Siddharth? Relax. Good. You guys are spending time. That's beautiful to look at.
Yes, my name is Dhananda. We'll talk about facials.
वेरी गुड शिवम, वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड, सो मोटिवेटिंग.
देखिए सबसे पहले आपको मैंने
ओप्स बट रिलैक्स 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 दिस इज अ डेफिनेशन नाउ हियर द डॉट प्रोडक्ट इज माइनस 12 प्लस 2c minus 6 is given as 6. Okay. 2c equal to 24. C equal to 12. Got it, everyone? Everyone got it? Good. Very good. Very good. Monisha, Monisha, what happened today? Again, beta, work done is defined as force into displacement. Dot product. Okay. So, okay, let's perform the dot product between these two vectors. Clear? Displacement is given, force is given. 3 into 4 is minus 12. C into 2 is plus 2C. 2 into minus 3 is minus 6 equal to 6 is what is given. Okay. Sure. Clear? Good. This is coming as 2C equal to 24, C equal to 12. Got it, everyone? Got it, got it, got it, got it, got it, got it, got it. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Leaderboard. Okay, now we'll have a shuffle. But no, because the gap was high. Very good, very good, very good, very good, very good. Aditya was the fastest one to respond. Very good. Here we go to the next question. Jagrav, good. A force F is applied over a particle which displaces it from original position to the point S is equal to this. The work done on the particle is. The work done on the particle is. The work done on the particle is what happens, Siddharth? There is a trap, but easy to cross. Easy to cross. You can consider there is a trap. The trap is just only to let you think, to like delay your response time. by some 3-4 seconds. Okay. Good. Right? Work done is just the dot product. 5 2s are 10. 3 into minus 1 is minus 3 plus 7. I just kept this minus 7 so that you will spend some time to think. Oops, like that. Okay. Yeah. Good, 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 good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Next question. Good, 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 good. Srijan was the fastest one. Minor difference of 100 plus points between Srijan and Jagrav. Very good. Sriram is also there. Raghav is also there. And here we go to the last question. Last question. Last question. Last question. Last question is just there to give you a relief. But if you guys remember, last question is the first question of the last quiz. That's what you call a word trap. Now I'll get who all remembers. What is happening in the class? This question, which is last question for today's quiz, was the first question of the last quiz. No, beta Dhruv, I want to, but not getting time a lot, like literally. I want to. Siddharth, you hate me. Thank you, Vachche. Thanks a lot. Seven people got it right, and you know, as the response of a cross product is a vector, it should be zero vector. Let's see the scenario. Damn you, Srijan! Oh, nice competition, yaar. Healthy competition. Healthy. Wow, Srijan. Like played really well. Wow, Jagrav. Very good. Very good. Very, very excellent. Jagrav, Srijan. Very excellent. Healthy game. Very good. Very good. Very good. Nice. Everyone. Good. Anyway, as I always say, these all things are the garnish thing. The cult, the core thing is the learning which is coming out of it. You can hate me for it. Okay. You can just take it for granted, but if you'll remember the learning outcome of this 1 hour, that is fairly enough for the efforts being put to create them. Thank you very much, guys. Thanks a lot. Good night.
Thank you, sir.
See you next week. Bye bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Amazing quiz.
Take care, Bachche. Take care.
Amazing quiz. Bye, sir.
Yeah. Bra 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 bra.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Vijay. Bye bye.